Well, ANC President Cyril Ramaphosa will deliver his inaugural speech after his election to the most powerful position in the party. Ramaphosa, a seasoned unionist, politician and businessman, has the longest experience on the party's National Executive Committee.
First day in office spent visiting stalls and interacting with various people. On his shoulders, he knows he carries the hopes of many as the leader of the Africa's oldest liberation movement. His eagerly awaited speech is expected to focus on unity of the party and the country. This after a bruising contest against rival Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma.
We have proven once again, maybe for the millionth time in our 105 years history of existence, that the ANC is able to rise even above its own strength. And here we were able to demonstrate that the ANC family, this great organization of our people, wants to emerge out of this conference united, renewed and stronger than it was when we came to conference.
The president may also touch on the economy to boost investor confidence.
And we thank the small and medium enterprise people, who we normally call hawkers, for being here. But we also spend time with the slightly bigger corporations that always come whenever the ANC holds its big events. It could be an NGC or a national conference. So they are here, and we also spend time going through what they are showcasing. Some of them are showcasing new technologies that they want to spread throughout the country.
Ramaphosa, who returned to prominent politics when he was elected deputy president in Mangaung in 2012, was Nelson Mandela's choice for deputy in 1994. As the ANC president, he's expected to evoke the vision of the most revered statesman, perhaps in what may be his bid to see some of it through. Mzwandile Mbeji, SABC News, Johannesburg.